Welcome back to Helen Source and Conquest of Doers. I decided to do a bit more work after this video, which I just uploaded just now, Local Elections 2018 Contextual Analysis, where I said I'd do a bit of graphing of the swings over the years. I've started putting together a blog on it, which is this document here. Wikipedia really is your friend. Let me just find that document. I've got a lot of stuff open on this computer, so I hope I can get this recorded without too much going to be this one. Yes, it is. So let's start from the beginning. In any contextual analysis, one really needs to understand what one's dealing with in terms of the system that we're analysing. Well, regional local elections in the UK, this is from Wikipedia, are run in different ways in different parts of the country, the union. So what happened in the current local elections was that the metropolitan boroughs and London boroughs largely were elected, and that happens every 4 years. So the analysis that I've got coming up, which I've started graphing, actually looks at the analogue to this election, which was 4 years ago in 2014, and I've gone all the way back every 4 years. I'm going to do a blog on this table here, which I've started putting together, which I'll figure out a way to graph this and maybe animate the graphing to sort of bring it to life for people who think more visually as opposed to in figures. Now in 2018, here we have an 8% swing to Labour, and a 3% swing away from both the Conservatives and the Lib Dems, and Labour fetched up with 2,365 councillors to the 1,332 and 536 councillors respectively for the Conservatives and the Lib Dems. In 2014, the swings were 2% to Labour, 4% to Conservatives, 1% away from Lib Dems. 2010, plus 1, minus 4, plus 1. You can see the performance in 2018 over 2010 and 14 is markedly better. 2006, well, in fact, it's better than all of those previous ones. Now, what we discover if we then go to the 94, what I've actually done here, because the swing figures aren't actually in the Wikipedia articles, but the overall number of councillors are. And what we actually discover is that back in 1994, all of the councillors were voted for in one go, and this staggered way of doing it now wasn't actually in existence. So to compare, say, 1995, which was Tony Blair's best year, or indeed any of these years prior to 98 or 99 when the new system came in the previous video I did, I sort of posed that as a question. I wasn't sure then, and but this narrows it down. But let's just, I'll get back to graphing this, which has helped me in terms of contextualizing what I've been doing here. Now, if we can just get to the right thing. Political makeup of local councils in the United Kingdom. Right, so this is really what everything is compared against. And you can see that after the local elections here, so as of 5th of May, the Conservatives have 9,100 councillors, and they're broken down county councils, district councils, London Metropolitan, other metropolitan, unitary authorities, Wales, Scotland, Northern Ireland. And so you've got Conservatives, Labour and Liberal Democrats have the lion's share. The SNP, obviously up in Scotland, have rather more, and Plaid Cymru in Wales. The Greens across all these different countries, 202. UKIP, 211. They had a disastrous thing the other day. I mean, effectively, they are self-destructing, I guess. But in terms of comparing previous years, what you really find is that the Conservatives, Labour and Liberal Democrats and what happens between those becomes significant. Now, another very interesting thing that we notice is county councils are all Conservative apart from Cumbria, which Cumbria, Nottinghamshire and Oxfordshire have no overall control, but Cumbria has a Labour and Liberal Democrat alliance by the looks of it, and the Conservatives and Independents keep these ones blue. The district councils, it's a bit more of a mixed picture. You see there are rather more Labour district councils. It's more balanced, but it's still overwhelmingly Conservative. Then scroll down, you can see the link here, political makeup for local councils in the United Kingdom, and then you get to the England unitary authorities, where again there's much more red, and then when you get to the metropolitan boroughs, it inverts in urban areas. You've got this Solihull, which is a Conservative kind of island in an otherwise Labour dominated scene, and London Borough Councils, you can see here again, it's an inversion pretty much of the County Council scene and the District Council scene. So that's worth looking at just to get a feel for number one, what the overall scene is, and then number two, what we're actually talking about in the elections that have just been. What we're actually doing here is indulging ourselves in a bit of sophology, which is scientific analysis of elections. I'll get around to doing some graphing, just sort of bring this home a bit. So, United Kingdom local elections 1995. Now, this is a big turning point, I think. You can see the overall popular vote percentage of 47%. This is when Tony Blair wasn't Prime Minister. He had become the leader of the Labour Party on the death of John Smith, but they basically picked up 1,800 additional councillors, and the Tories lost 2,000 in that election. Now, this system was, they were all done at once, and there wasn't this staggered thing. So it's harder to compare because the But as you can see, the winning parties here, there's very little blue there. I mean, this is the nadir of the Tories under John Major. I mean, I guess really when he was battling his bastards, really, if we think about it. And around about that time you had the Maastricht Treaty, all the fallout from there, you had the exchange rate mechanism, and a lot of pretty sort of traumatic stuff happened, this sort of Tony Blair back then was the equivalent of Macron now in France. Perhaps they'll find out sooner in France, so we had to wait until 2003 to confirm that Tony Blair was a con man. But I'm trying to be objective about this and not sort of allow animus that I feel towards certain of these people to get in the way. I met John Major once, actually. I was presented to him at the opening of the Limehouse Link, funnily enough. He was a really nice chap. I don't agree with him politically. But certainly I found him to be a thoroughly decent gentleman when I met him all but briefly. And I think I said something like, you've got much better things to do than talk to the likes of me, you know. Pleased to meet you. And I had David Mellor's wife pushing me in the back, Lady Watson. She was really keen to meet him and sort of blow smoke up his arse. I forget her name now. That's another time, another life. Right, where are we? 97, so that's the landslide general election victory, and they basically haven't said what happened there. Local elections 2004, is that in the cycle that we're interested in? Let's have a look. 18, 14, 10, 6, 2, 98, 94. So, let's just get two of those ones. 2010, 2006, yeah, that's right. So let's just '98. So this is the cycle then that we want to be looking at. You can see here by the number of councillors involved, this is when John Smith, they had 40% of the popular vote then. So 94. Let's check here again. Yeah, 94. The main opposition, the Labour Party, gained 44 seats, bringing the number of councillors to 95,257. The projected national vote share was 40%, a 1% increase on the 93 local elections. The Conservative lost 516 seats and were left with 7,000 councillors. Their projected national vote share was 28%, a 3% fall since previous local elections in 93. Liberal Democrats gained 428 seats. So that was still under the old system. And then 98, again, that was, right, where are we? Local elections took place in the way 98. All under borough council seats were elected, as well as a third of the seats. So this is the new system. So this is comparable to the one we've just had. And in this one, you see the Tories picked up an additional 256 seats and 8 councils. Labour won 94 councils, picked up 2, but lost overall 88 councillors. And they had 38% of the vote. So that was Blair's first, early days of Blair as Prime Minister. 2002, see here now. Two percent swing to Labour, 33% of the popular vote. Conservatives got 34% of the popular vote, but a 6% swing away from them. They picked up an additional 9 councils. So there we are. You see, Charles Kennedy did okay there, but Ian Duncan Smith, although they suffered a big swing, you know, they would have settled for that, I think. In the recent one, 2006, so here we've got Cameron, he got 39% of the popular vote, a 1% swing away from them, picked up 11 councils. Blair, 2% swing away from him, lost 17 councils and 319 councillors. That's 2006. Then we get to 2010, the general election took place at the same time, a bit more data here, swing of 4% away from the Conservatives and 1% towards Gordon Brown. They picked up 17 councils, the Tories lost 4. It was a hung election, as you remember, and they formed the disastrous coalition, the austerity coalition, with Nick Clegg, for which we've all been paying since. And you know, that's the, it sort of ushered in this era of fascist politics, I would argue. So that's 2010. 2011. Now, obviously, what we want to do is look at the like for like, so we have to go to 2014. The reason 2011 is interesting is that the swing was 10% to Ed Miliband. They picked up an additional 26 councils and 857 councillors. Now, there we are. Direct elections were held in 36 metropolitan boroughs, 194 second tier, ordinary. So basically, there was a lot more seats up in that 2011 one than elsewhere, than in the 2018 one. So it's not directly comparable, but was one of the better performances, or outstanding performances, I would say. And that came under Ed Miliband in 2011. 2012. What do we want? 2014 for the next comparable one. 2014, here we have it. This under Ed Miliband, 31% of the popular vote, 2% swing, 82 councils, picked up 6, 2,121 councillors. And then this one there, this should be 2018. I have to say, I know a little bit about how these pages on Wikipedia are actually edited, and they're edited by mainly Tory and Lib Dem activists who do play politics with the Wikipedia articles, and anyway, on the popular vote, 35-35, even Stevens, a swing of 4% to Labour, 6% to Conservatives, and 3% away from the Liberal Democrats, and they've taken UKIP out. Now, I don't really want to get involved in the editing on all of this, but let's have a quick look at the talk on this to see if there are any editing battles going on. Here we are, this guy here, Bondeng Gezou. I had a big bust up with him on the Green Party articles back in the leadership elections in 2016. This is the degree of vandalism that goes on to stop proper analysis is risible. Let's see here we are. Let's see who's been sticking their ear in here. There's my friend Bondigazoo. Anyway, yeah, that article is being interfered with to get in the way of the truth. So let's just go back here to the up-to-date state of play on the BBC News website. I think this results in full. That's what we want, really. Let's have a look at those. So, Labour picked up 77. Conservative lost 33, Lib Dems up 75, Green up 8, UKIP down 123. Now, and this is the ridiculous thing, parties neck and neck at the finish line. Each, according to this. Right, I'm not going to get into trying to figure out how these figures are being spun. It's disappointing that the Wikipedia article on the 2018 local elections is clearly being messed about with to make it difficult to compare with the other key data available, but I'll get and unravel all of that. To sum up, the big stories are clearly the collapse of the UKIP vote. In 2014, although there was a swing away from UKIP, they picked up quite a lot of councillors. In 2014, there was a swing towards both Labour and Tories, although much larger towards the Tories. Popular vote 31, 29, 13 and 17%, and it's this 17% coming across from UKIP which is making a big difference. Extrapolating into the general election, you have to be quite careful because another thing is turnout, and the turnout in these elections is mainly for people who've already made up their mind. Let's just see what else we've got here that we want to just be comparing. No, I think I'm going to finish it there, and I will do some more work on my blog, and I'm going to get stuck into some of the data that isn't being interfered with. So let's just wrap that up for now.